Hello everyone, welcome to the lectures on Transportation Engineering 2. Today we will learn in this lecture about the speeds as well as speed studies as well as origin and destination studies. First of all, we will start with the speed studies. What are the speed studies? Are necessary because the actual speed of the vehicle over a particular portion may vary depending upon the various factors such as geometric features, traffic conditions, time, environment and travel. It varies from time to time as well as. In this speed, we will study some of the some kind of speeds, that is the number one we will learn, the spot speeds. The spot speed only, then we will learn about running speed, then we will learn about journey speed, and after that two main speeds, those are time mean speed as well as the space mean speed. In short, we can this is can be written as TMS, right? The last one, that is the space mean speed. This is nothing but the SMS. So these five units we will learn about these five studies, that is spot speed, running speed, journey speed, time mean speed and space mean speed. So first of all we will start with the spot speed. So what is the spot speed? In general, the spot speed is the instantaneous speed of the vehicle at a particular time, at a particular location. The instantaneous speed of the vehicle at a specific time, at a specified location is generally known as the spot speed. Let's take an example. Suppose this is an road. This is a particular section, a point where we are interested to measure the spot speed of the vehicle. This section is selected or is taken as for the study. So this is the section. Suppose then at this point of vehicles which are vehicles those are passing from this section, the speed of that vehicle at this particular point will be the spot speed of that vehicle. So this will be the speed of the vehicle at the speed of the vehicle at this particular location will be known as the spot speed of that vehicle. We have certain methods for finding the spot speeds. We have so many methods of finding the spot speeds of a vehicle, but the most most easy or generally preferred method to calculate the spot speed is by using the ionoscope. An ionoscope, what we generally do, we generally take a rod under study, generally 50 meter rod stretch. Let's check there, this is the 150 meter rod stretch. This length can be vary from 30 meter to 50 meter. Generally we are taking it to as 50 meter. Here one observer will stand at this point. So as the vehicle will enter from this point, this observer will start his stopwatch. So he can he will just take the time when the vehicle will just enter this point. So his entry time will be taken and the stopwatch will be running continuously. Here the ionoscope will be installed at this place. It's a prism kind of instrument, or we can say it's a kind of mirror thing. When this vehicle will cross this section, the mirror the image of this vehicle will be seen, will be captured by this mirror and it will be reflected. That image will be seen to this observer. So as this observer will see the image of the vehicle into this prism or to say the mirror, he will stop his stopwatch. So he will get the time required for the vehicle to just cross. So he will get the time required for that vehicle to just cross this 50 meter broad stretch. And then you know that speed is nothing but distance divided by time. So distance we know that it is 50 meter, 30 meters second, while the time is recorded with the help of this is stopwatch. So by using this formula, we can find out this broad speed of that vehicle. If the ionoscope is not available, then we can do some alternate also to find out this broad speed. What is that at the place of this object, at the place of this telescope, we will we will ask, we will just look appoint one more observer at this point. So we will be having two observer, every observer will be having a stopwatch. Each observer will be having a stopwatch. So as the beaker will enter this portion, observer number one will start the stopwatch, and at the time when the beaker will cross this section, this observer number two will give a sign to this observer number one. This observer number one will stop the stopwatch at the time, and the time required for that vehicle to cross this 50 meter of road distance will be noted down or will be recorded. So later on, with this formula, that is, speed equals to distance divided by time. With this, so distance is known to us, the time is recorded with the help of a stopwatch. So by using this formula, we can find out this road speeds. So after this, next we will learn about running speed or the journey speed. Running speed, and the next one is journey speed. Journey speed is also known as overall speed or the travel speed. So let's write here the travel speed only. We will understand these two type of speed with an example. Suppose this is the point A, and I am interested to travel from this point A to point B. Point B is somewhere here. Point B is this is the point A, that is the point B. I am interested to travel from point A to point B. The distance between point A and point B, let's say this is the 300 kilometer. For an example, this is just an example. We will try to learn what is running speed and what is travel speed with this example. So I am interested to travel from point A to point B. The distance between point A and point B is 300 km. I started at a particular time, that it can be, let's say, 10 a.m. or it can be any time. I started morning at 10 a.m. from this point A, and I want my destination is point B. I traveled near about 80 km. For an example, I traveled near about 80 km. This took near about 1.5 hours for me to reach at this place. Here I found traffic jam. I found traffic jam here, and it took almost 1/2 hour for me to cross this point. Here it can be any junction, it can be anything, due to anything. I found the traffic jam here, and it required 1/2 hour for me to clear this traffic jam. And again I traveled after that near about 120 km. So after this point, again I stopped myself. It may be due to fatigue vision, or I want to have an lunch, or it can be anything, but due to tiredness, or due to the rest to be given for the weekend, due to anything. Suppose, sir, I stopped after this traveling 120 km from this point. Let's take an example. We stopped ourselves on our lunch, and we just took 1 hour here for having food. Again, we started traveling. Let's travel again 60 km. We traveled for next 60 km, and we were forced to stop just because of breakdown of the vehicle. It can it is also a kind of delay, again it took almost 1/2 hour for us to repair the vehicle, and then we completed after that our rest of remaining 40 km journey. So this for traveling this 20 km, we do the 1.5 hour again. We found the traffic jam here. So to clear this traffic jam, the delay was 1/2 hour, but it took 1/2 hour to complete this. After that, we traveled this 120 km. Let's take it to almost 2 hours to travel this 120 km distance. Then at this point, it was the breakdown of the vehicle. This breakdown of the vehicle took almost 1 hour. Here we stopped for lunch, or can be anything. For this lunch, we just spent it 1 hour, then we traveled 60 km. After 60 km, it was the breakdown of the vehicle. It took almost 1/2 hour for repair. This 1/2 hour, suppose it also took 1 hour to travel, and this 40 km also took 1 hour to travel. So this is the whole summary about our traveling, about our journey. So we traveled 80 km in 1.5 hour, then 1/2 hour was required to clear the traffic jam, and 120 km we traveled. It took 2 hours for this journey. Then we were tired or didn't do anything, or we had the lunch or extend anything. We take a halt of 1 hour almost, then we traveled again 60 km. Then due to breakdown of the vehicle, again we stopped and it took almost half an hour to repair the vehicle. Then last of all, 40 km journey we completed in 1 hour. So this all gives us the summary of our journey. So if for this particular case, if I have asked to calculate the running speed, then what it will be? So what will be the running speed? The running speed will be the total, always first of all, what is the speed? The speed is nothing but the distance divided by time. So if you are finding, if you are interested to find any kind of speed, we know the total of we know that overall distance is nothing but the 300 km, because we have traveled from point A to point B, and the distance between point A and point B is 300 km. So distance will remain same. Only the time is the only one factor which will affect the speed. So as we are taking the running speed, means what? The running time will be taken here. So what is the running speed? Running speed is nothing but the distance divided by running time. So distance determines time. Here we will take the running time. What is the running time? When the vehicle was in motion. The running time means that when the vehicle was in motion, that time is considered as running time. So for this particular example, the running time is what? When you were traveling to 30 km, the vehicle was in motion. Vehicle was running for this 1.5 hours. After that, for traveling to 20 km, the vehicle was in motion. For that, it took 2 hours to complete this distance. And after that, for this 60 km also, the vehicle was in motion. For this again, it took 1 hour for travel. And again, for last 40 km, it was in motion. For this again, it took 1 hour for travel. So total running time will be this 1.5 hours plus 2 hours plus 1 hour plus 1 hour. So this will be our running time. So means what? 1.5 hour. This and this running time, that is 2 hours. Plus again for this 60 km, again it is in running. So for this again it requires the 1 hour. Then for this last 40 kilometers again it was in running speed. The time required for that running time was 1 hour. So this 300 km divided by the total running was, the total running time was how much? 2 plus 1 3, 3 plus 1 4, 4 plus 5, 5 and half hours. So it was in running for 5.5 hours. Whatever we get, this will be its running speed. This is the running speed. Whatever it will be, 300 km divided by 5.5 hours, this will give us the running speed. So what is the running speed? It is the speed of the vehicle when the vehicle was in motion, when the vehicle was traveling, when the vehicle was not stopped. We generally don't consider the delays in this. Whatever these are, 1 hour which is required for clearing a traffic jam, the 1 hour due to anything we stop, either for lunch or it can be tiredness or for any kind of delay, can be related to anything, this is okay. Again, this half an hour, this is the delay due to the vehicle breakdown. This is time required to repair the vehicle. Or if suppose we got stuck somewhere and there is on signal, we stop for 2 minutes, we stop for 3 minutes. If we are passing from the city center, that will also be considered as delay. So whatever delay we are having on, so whatever delays are occurring on a on journey, we generally exclude all those the delay in the running speed. So what is the running speed? It is the speed of, if so, what is running speed? It is the speed of the vehicle when the vehicle is in motion, when the vehicle is running. So the distance divided by the running time. So this running time, I always exclude the delay. So that's why only we have considered only the running time, that is 1.5 hour, 2 hour, this 1 hour, this 1 hour. This is giving us the running speed. Now let's take the other example of this, that is journey speed. Journey speed is also known as the overall speed, or it is the travel speed.
But the distance,
that is the constant, There is no change, the distance is not affecting the speed at all. The factor which is affecting these speeds, that is the time that divided by total travel time or the total journey time. Here the term will be including delay. Because the total travel time we are considering, it will be included. Total travel time means the running time plus delay. It will be including all the delay. The delay can be due to anything. So for this example, if you are interested to find out the journey speed, what it will be, the distance will be same, that is the 300 divided by the total running time plus any delay. So it will consider this 1.5 hour for which the vehicle was in motion plus this 1/2 hour to create a traffic jam plus this 2 hour. For which the vehicle is in motion, then again 1 hour plus this 1 hour, then again half an hour plus 1 hour. So this is the what total travel time, the time required to complete that travel, to complete that journey. That is so, it will be again, what we can write it, it can be 1.5 plus this 1/2 hour time to clear the traffic jam. Particularly the delay time to be general, it will be specifically, it will be the delay time. Then again this 2 hours, again this 1 hour delay time, then this 1 hour traveling time, after this is 1/2 hour again delay, the time which is required for repairing the vehicle, then last one, this is again last 1 hour to complete the journey. So this will be the total journey speed. So 300 divided by this will be total 1, 2 plus 1, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6.5, 7 and 7.5 hours. So whatever it will be, we can get, that will give us, that will be the journey speed. The journey speed is what? It is the distance divided by the total travel time including the delay. This is the journey speed. So this is the basic difference between the running speed and the journey speed.
Doing this study, that is 50 kmph, 40 kmph, 60 kmph,
65 km/h and 45 km/h. So these speeds what we got after doing the study at this point. These speeds we got after doing the study at this particular point for a duration of half an hour. So, and we are asked to find out the time mean speed for this. So what will be time mean speed? The time mean speed will be the average of this for the speed. Then what kind of average? We take the simple average, or to say that particularly or very specifically, the arithmetic mean of these for the speed gives us the time mean speed. So what is the time mean speed? The time mean speed is nothing but it will be summation di divided by n, where I varies from 1 to n. This is what the time mean speed. This is what the time mean speed. If we want to calculate the time mean speed for this particular point, then it will be this is equals to 50 summation of VR. VR is varies from 1 to n. Here n is 5 because we are having the 5 data. So what it will be? It will be 50 plus 40 plus 60 plus 65 plus 45 divided by n is 5. So this will give us the time mean speed required for this point. If we will solve this, we will get 52 km/h. This will be the time mean speed.
At a specified time,
over a specified period, over a specified location, these five vehicles were in this study area. The spot speed of the average of the spot speed of this vehicle will give us the stress mean speed. What kind of average we will take here? The harmonic average of harmonic mean of the spot speed will give us the stress mean speed. That is what given in terms of definition. That is what it is defined as the average speed of all the vehicles occupying a given section of highway over a specified time. The specified time is nothing but the instant time here. That is, let's say 10 a.m. It can be any time. For this particular time, over this specified location, this first the harmonic mean of these vehicles will give us the stress mean speed. So this can be calculated as the half stress mean speed will be BS will be n, that is number of vehicle, number of observation divided by summation of 1 by we added I varies from 1 to n. So this will be, so if by using this formula we can find out the space mean speeds of space mean speed of our highway. Suppose these are the spot speeds given 50, 40, 60, 60 and 45. These are the spot speeds of a vehicle and we are asked to find out the space mean speed of this vehicle. How we can, how we find out that? So first of all, let's calculate 1 by VI, but directly use this formula, that is VS equals to the number of observation, that is n, n is nothing but the 5, because we have the 5 observation, that is 50, 40, 60, 65 and 45. So n will be the 5 divided by 1 by VI, we will calculate the VR given, that is spot speeds of the vehicle. So it will be summation of all will be 1 by 50 plus 1 by 40 plus 1 by 60 plus 1 by 65 plus 1 by 45. If you will do this, this is what, this is nothing but, this term is nothing but summation of 1 by, this term represents this one, that is this denominator. So if you will solve this whole term, then we get this space mean speed. This will be 50.37. This is the mean speed. If again in this space mean speed, if the data is given in the form of frequency table, what is frequency table? We have seen in previous one. In case of time mean speed, if again the data is given in the form of frequency table, then how to calculate this space mean speed? We have a formula for that. What it will be, the space mean speed will be summation of fi, I varies from 1 to n, divided by summation fi divided by vi, where the I varies from 1 to n. This will give us the stress mean speed. If the data is given in the form of frequency table, this formula will give us the stress mean speed, that is summation of fi where I varies from 1 to n divided by summation of fi divided by vi, where vi is the speed of ith vehicle and fi is the speed of the number of vehicles having the speed vi. So by using this, you can calculate the space mean speed if the data is given in the form of the frequency table. Let's take an example. Let's solve one numerical on this. This is what the question is given. The results of the spot speed study is given in the form of frequency table, frequency distribution table, and we are asked to find out the time mean speed and the space mean speed. So how we will calculate it? First of all, we will write the speed is given in kmph. Then the next word we have, that is the frequency. F, let's call this as g. The speed is given range from 2 to 5 first, then 6 to 9. then 10 to 13. After that we have 14 to 17. So this is what given. The frequency is also given. There is 1407. 1407. Okay, and what we are asked? We are asked to find out the spelling speed as well as the specimen speed. What will be timing speed? Clear, this is frequency table, the timing speed will be. Summation VI FI divided by summation F. Where the specimen speed? So, it is the timing speed, VT. Where the specimen speed? Will be summation F divided by summation FI divided by VI. This will be the specimen speed. So, the frequency is given, that F is given. If we do, we can get the summation F from here. But, so we will get summation F and summation F from this table. But to solve the specimen speed, timing speed, timing speed, and specimen speed, we need to calculate the VI FI as well as F by VI. So we have the V, this is V, this is F. So we can get, if we will multiply, this right side is the column number 1, this is the column number 2. So this column number 3, this column number 3, if I multiply column number 1 and column number 2, I will get the summation of VF. Similarly, for this column number 4, if I do column number 2 divided by column number 1, divided by column number 1, I will get the F divided by V. So, by this column number 4, I will get the summation of, if I will get the F by V, if I will take the summation, I will get this term, as well as for 10 minute speed, if I take the summation of column number 3, I will get the summation VF. So, if I get all those values, I can calculate the 10 minute speed as well as the specimen speed. So, but before that, we have to take one more here. Speed is given in terms of, in a range, that 2 to 5. We have to take the middle limit. So that we will make some little bit change here. Or we just vary. Calculate the VF. VF, that is column number 3, is nothing but a multiplication of 1 and 2. 1 is this one, 2 is this one. So what it is, 3.5 into 1, it will be 3.5 only. 7.5 into 4, it will be 30. Here 11.5 into 0, it will be 0. Well, 15.5 into 7, this will be 108.5. Now the last one is what we understood, you can write the f by v. What is f? F, that is column number 2, it is the column number 1, that is 2 by 1. So if we do 1 divided by 3.5, this will be 0.29. This 0.29 will be what? 1 divided by 3.5. Similarly, here we will do 4 divided by 7.5, the 2 divided by 1. This will be, this is what? 4 divided by 7.5. Here it will be 0 divided by 11.5, so it will be 0. By the last, it will be 7 divided by 15.5, this will be 0.45. So now let's take the summation of required column. That is, first of all, we will take the summation n. This is frequency, so summation n will be from here 7 plus 1, 8 plus 4, 12. Well, here summation bf. Summation bf will be, if we take summation of all these two, it will be 142, as well as summation of f by b. If we take summation of all these four, it will be 1.28. So now we got all the summation of all the respective columns. Now we can easily begin find out the time mean speed as well as space mean speed. So what will be the time mean? Vt, the time mean speed will be summation of vi and fi. Summation of vf is here, that is what, 142 divided by summation f, that is 12. If we solve this, we will get it as 11.83. The data was given in kmph, so it will be 11.83 kmph. Similarly, we will try to solve the space mean speed. Summation f is nothing but 12. Let us see here, summation fi divided by vi, that is 1.28. So if you solve this, it will be 9.375. This is the space mean speed for this particular. Like this, we can solve the time mean speed as well as the space mean speed for the frequency table. Now let's switch to origin and destination studies. First of all, we'll see what are the objectives, why to conduct the origin and destination studies. So the first one is, origin and destination studies is carried out mainly for what? The first one is to plan the road network and other facilities for vehicular traffic. Means what? Suppose this is the origin point, point A. We are having a road, it's going this. Here we are having a town or we are having a city, which are having a certain roads, and then we are crossing to this way, and then this road goes to somewhere this place. Here it can be the anything, it can be the IT hub, or it can be some central business area, or it can be to any social connectivity place, or it can be anything. Here we have the huge traffic volume, we just start from this point, it enters to this town. It can be a city, or it can be any place, or it can be anything. So if the traffic is starting from this point, once it reaches at this point, it enters into this town, and then it faces all the city traffic, or all the other two-wheeler traffic, or all the traffic related to this city. It passes from all those things, and again it just comes on this highway, and then it reaches to this place. Let's call this place as B. So what it can be, so if the when a heavy commercial vehicle or it can other type of vehicle is entering into this town, it can cause the delay for those, because here the speed of its speed limit speed will be limited on this area, so the travel time will increase, so it can increase the delay for this particular vehicle, for this as well as it can cause the conditions because the extra traffic is entering in the city, so the number of traffic flow, the traffic volume will increase, it can cause the traffic jam also, or sometimes it can lead to some accidents also. If we are finding that the huge number of traffic which is starting from this point, they are interested to reach at the point B, so this traffic, so what we can plan, the other kind of what we plan, we can plan after doing some study, we can plan a bypass from this point. This bypass can cross like this also, this bypass can be something like this also. From outdoor of the city, so this traffic will not enter into the city, this traffic from out, this traffic is coming from point A, at this point only, this traffic will take bypass and directly it will take to this point, so it will save its time as well as it will save its distance. So, by doing this origin destination studies also, we can plan this kind of road network. What else we can do? Suppose this is the origin point, traffic is starting from this point. On the road section, here we are having a junction. Traffic started from this point. Here we are having junction. What will happen? This traffic would get to go this side also. This traffic would get to go this side. This side also, and traffic would come to this side. As well as traffic which is coming, if they will try to go in this direction. Someone will try to go this side. Someone will try to go this side. What will happen? If these are causing, the movement of these traffic is causing the conflict points. But the most of the traffic is want to travel in a straight direction. It may be due to central business area, or it can be central business district, central business area, it can be anything. The most of traffic is traveling to in is traveling in a straight direction. So what we can do to just keep them away from this traffic which is coming from this direction, the traffic those are interested to go in this direction, as well as the traffic those are interested to go in this direction. We will try to keep them free from all this traffic. So for that, what we can do on the behalf of this origin destination study, we can provide a flyover from this place to this place, a flyover from this place to this place. So we will, so we can provide the kind of uninterrupted flow for this. We can design kind of uninterrupted flow for these vehicles. We can design a flyover from this place to this place. It will be kind of one kind of facility, traffic facility. It can be one kind of the road facility for the vehicle. The vehicle which is coming from this direction, directly they can take this flyover and they can reach to this direction. There is no need to, this traffic will not get interrupted from the traffic which is coming from this direction, as well as traffic which is coming from this direction, those are interested to go in this direction, they can directly go straight away. So this is one of the advantages. So by just on the behalf of this point A study, we can plan this kind of we can plan this kind of flyovers also. So to plan this is also kind of one facility. So on the behalf of this origin destination study, we can plan for this kind of facility as well as for different kind of road networks also. Then the second thing what we have, that is to plan the schedule of different modes of transport for the trip demand of commuters. Generally, the trend what we can see, that is we have the peak flow in the morning as well as the peak flow in the evening time, because in morning people start their journey for their offices or to school or to the college, right? It can be anything generally. So we have the high flow in the morning as well as we have the high flow or the peak flow in the evening, when the people generally used to return to their places. So generally we have the high flow in morning as well as in evening. But if suppose, irrespective of this flow, if the municipal corporation, if we take the example of within the city, the municipal corporation is running the public transport at every 1 hour. Suppose this is a point A, this is the point B. The municipal corporation is running the public transport in between at every frequency of every 1 hour. Bus starts from this point A in morning 9 o'clock. After that, the next bus starts at 10 o'clock, then 11 o'clock, then 12 o'clock. The frequency of bus is 1 hour, irrespective of the peak flow or the peak time. Then this will be the problem for commuters, because the main commuter demands is when? The main especially the demand from the commuter side, is either during morning or from evening, because the peak flow is very high during that time. So on the day of this urgent destination study, we can find a major number of people are traveling in morning and they are returning in evening. So how we can plan public transport? If suppose the peak flow in morning is during 7 to 9 hours, 7 am to 9 am. So during this time, increase the efficiency of vehicle. Let's start the public transport at every half an hour rather than 1 hour. First was at 7 am, then 7:30, then 8 am. And even when within this peak flow, we find out that in between 8:50 to 8:45, we have tremendous traffic flow in between this 8:15 to 8:45. So in between this time, we can start the bus at every duration of 10 minutes. So like this, we can increase the frequency and we can reduce the frequency on the behalf of demand. That demand we can find out on the basis of this urgent destination study. So we can plan the trips on the basis of this committed demands. This is the example of the road transport. If the road transport is not sufficient to carry that much the flow, then we can plan for some other kind of mode of transport. What are those? Either the local train or metro train, they can also be planned for this urgent destination study. So these are the objectives of O&D study. Then we have the various applications of this O&D study. Before that, we will see that what we generally do in this O&D. O&D gives the information like the actual direction of travel, in which direction the vehicle is traveling, whether suppose it is started to travel from this point ahead, this is a junction. So whether he would like to go straight or he will take the left turn or he will take the right turn, the actual direction of travel, then the selection of route, why he selected that route only, if there is some other route, then he might have selected that route only. So what is the particular route, what is the particular reason behind selecting this particular route only, that is purpose for selecting this route. Then the length of trip, if suppose he has started his journey from this point A and his journey will end at this point B, the length of this trip, the distance, this also we have to note down for this particular road. This also we need to collect under the O&D study. Then the length, apart from this, what is, as when we were discussing the purpose for selecting, the why he selected that particular road, the reason, like it can be sometimes the social connectivity, or he is connected or he may be connected to that road due to any kind of reason. So then he tries to take down, try to take the particular reason why he is selecting that kind of or that particular road. So generally these kind of information we collect under the O&D survey. We have several application of this O&D survey. What are those? The first one is to judge the adequacy of existing road and to use its planning new network of roads. What it can be, suppose we are already having a two-lane highway. Suppose we are already having a two-lane highway and the capacity for this two-lane highway, suppose let's say 3000 vehicles per day. This is a two-lane two-way highway. Let's say this is a two-lane two-way highway and the capacity for this two-lane two-way highway is 3000 vehicles per day. But right now, this gap, the traffic volume has increased. This has increased from 3000 to, let's say, 5000. This traffic volume has increased from 3000 to 5000 vehicle per day. Now, this road is not capable to serve this much traffic, that is 5000 vehicle per day. What we can do on the way of this? We can decide to go from 2 lane to 4 lane, or we can make it from 2 lane to 3 lane. So on the way to judge the adequacy, that the capacity for this was 3000 vehicle per day only, but right now the capacity has increased, it is not capable to serve that much traffic. So we can plan the new kind of road or new network or new kind of a new improvement. What that can be, either we can go from 2 lane to 4 lane, we can convert it from 2 lane to 4 lane, that is, this is for ongoing, this is for upcoming. We can plan a new we can improve the existing facility. Or what we can do, we can try to find out why the traffic has increased on this road. Earlier it was 3000 only, right now why it has increased to 5000. The people might be interested to go somewhere here, they might be traveling from this point, so they are going from this, like this, from this to this. traveling from this point to this point. Earlier the capacity for this was 3000 vehicle only. Now this point has some social connectivity. So, but the people don't have any new road or any other road from this place to this place. So they are forced to use this road only. They generally used to travel from here, from here to where they have some other kind of road. So this traffic capacity has increased from 3000 to 5000. So there is demand. We can find out that there is demand for one new road or one new road network from this place to this place. So on the behalf of this, we can plan a new road. So on the behalf of this, we can plan a new road network also from this place to this place. So the capacity of this again, people will use. It may be either again 3000 or it can be less than 3000. And the existing or the interested traffic or reduced traffic, then we use this road facility. So like this, we can judge the adequacy of the road network. Then the next, the application of this is to locate the expressway, terminals, new bypass, bridges as per the traffic demands. As we have seen in this in the previous point, during the object that we can plan in some situation, the flyovers, we can plan some kind of icelines to provide the free left movement. So for that kind of, in that way also we can, this is also one kind of application of O&D survey, that is to locate expressways, terminals, new bypass, bridges as per the traffic demand, then to establish design standards for the road, bridges and culverts along the routes. And last one, to locate the intermediate stops of the public transport. That is, suppose people are traveling from this point to this point. This is the point A, this is the point B. Here they have to stop at this point, at this point, and at this point. They are supposed to be traveling from public transport. The bus has a spot at these 3 points, but here we have some, there is one college, school, or hospital, or can be any important thing. So a stop is needed in this place. The people who are starting their journey from this point, their destination is this only. So, on the behalf of O&D studies also, we can plan a bus stop, an intermediate bus stop at this place also. This is also one of the application of O&D study. So, in today's class, we have seen the speeds, various kinds of speed. That is, first of all, we saw the spot speed, then we learn about running speed, then we learn about journey speed, then we learn about time mean speed, then space mean speed, then we switch to origin and destination studies. In that we learn what are the objectives of origin and destination studies, and at last we learn the various applications of origin and destination studies. So, thank you.